This 1986 British drama film brings to life the experiences of a Jesuit missionary in 18th century South America. Written by Robert Bolt and directed by Roland Jaffe, the movie features such modern-day stars as Robert De Niro, Jeremy Irons, and Liam Neeson. It has been elected number one on the Church Times Top 50 Religious Films. The movie follows a story of a Spanish Jesuit priest who enters the South American jungle to build a mission and convert a Guarani community to Christianity. Father Gabriel's mission is depicted as a place of sanctuary and education. The film follows the simple Christian themes depicted in 1 Corinthians 13, 4-13. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always preserves. Love never fails. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Love is the essence of Christianity. Christians are taught that the most important things in life are to believe in God with all your heart, mind, and strength, and to love your neighbor. God is viewed as the ultimate source of love, which we reflect and mirror in our own loving relationships with others. Regardless of whether someone is an enemy, God teaches us to love our enemies. It is through being generous, forgiving, and compassionate in which Christians learn to love one another unconditionally. Matthew 5:44 states, "Love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you." The Christian love is displayed by the Guarani tribe upon Mendoza's arrival. At the beginning of the film, Mendoza is an enemy of the Guarani people because he kidnapped them and sold them to nearby plantations to work as slaves. However, after falling into a depressive state, Father Gabriel invites him to join the Christian community.
I think that anyone who sinned deserves to be forgiven, and I think that's what God would want.
Mendoza carries his armor and sword miles to the Guarani as a sign of penance for his actions in the past. After falling to his knees in front of the people and crying, the tribesmen of all comfort Mendoza and show that they are accepting of him, regardless of the pain and suffering he had caused their people in the past. The tribe's forgiveness of Mendoza's actions is what brings Mendoza to tears and laughter. Through their forgiveness, they demonstrate Christian love and emulate the teachings of Christ in the Bible. The film's cinematography is stunning. However, critics claim that the rhythm of the movie is problematic. Many critics note how the viewer experiences the film as an anticlimax. Others note the disorganization of the battle scene at the end of the film. At a time when it is crucial for the viewer to understand who the Indians are and who they are fighting and how the battle is going, the scenes are staged chaotically. Some critics go as far as to label the film as anti-religious, on the grounds that Mendoza was accepted by the church and went against his vows by taking military action, even though they were defending the church.
Yes, I do think Rodrigo is right to defend the church and take military actions against the Portuguese, because I do think it was for a just cause. Even though it was against his vows, I think Rodrigo took a vow to serve the church, and in doing so, it kind of called him to take military action against the Portuguese and to protect the people that accepted him, even after all his sins and wrongdoing. So I think Rodrigo was definitely in the right to take military action against the Portuguese. Even though they came up short, I don't think that it was punishable.
Not only does the brilliance of the acting bring to life the Christian love and what it means to be part of something bigger than oneself, but the actors themselves found a renewed faith when filming. In an interview with Retta Blaney, Liam Neeson admitted that he was at a crossroads in his life, with reasonable success as an actor with a potential career ahead of him. As is popular with many young actors, Neeson lived a life of late-night partying and tomfoolery. However, through his Jesuit research, Neeson made a discovery that deeply affected his outlook. He learned about the spiritual exercises of Jesuit founder St. Ignatius Loyola. This brought together two big parts of his life. The Irish Catholic side was married to the life of an actor, and I found out acting could be a form of prayer, Neeson said. Neeson left the jungles of South America with a new perspective on life, and today he looks back at the filming of The Mission as a turning point in his career. The biggest takeaway from this movie expresses itself in the form of undeniable Christian love. God's love is eternal, and no matter what kind of obstacles or horrors one faces in their lifetime, the light always shines through the darkness.